How often do people visit your website or Shopify page and then leave because they have a question? Well, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add a free AI chatbot so you can make more sales and keep customers on your site. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And in this tutorial, we are going to be using an app called Tidio, which not only is going to provide us with a professional chatbot that we can put on any website or Shopify page, but we can also use the power of AI so we or someone else on our team does not have to be answering things directly. So here on the Tidio website, we want to go to the top right-hand corner and select Get Started. And here we can go ahead and create our own free account. And once complete, our very next step is to start configuring our live chat bot. So it's going to give us a preview here on the right-hand side of the screen. First, we're going to have to decide on a name. Now, this could either be the name of the avatar that you are going to be using. Sometimes businesses like to use a fake name or a fictional name. Or depending on where you are going to be placing your chatbot, it could be something like chat with support, or maybe you want to say chat with customer service, something along those lines. In this case, I'm going to use my name because remember, we don't have to use the AI capability all of the time. You can actually chat directly with your customers if you want to. Now, down below, we get to choose our color scheme. Now, you can choose from a number of presets. If we hit this more button, we have a number of others to choose from, or we can of course customize what we want as well. And last but not least, and I highly recommend this, we get to upload our avatar. So here you might want to either choose a logo, a picture of yourself, or in my case, because I'm going to be selling coaching services, I'm going to use this coach icon here. So they maybe recognize me as Coach Scott, so this is going to be helpful to them. And I think I'm going to go back to this. I kind of like this default blue here. Lastly, you just want to confirm your default chat language and then select continue. Now, in order for Tidio to personalize your experience, there's a couple of questions we need to answer. So for example, what is your main focus? Do I want to increase sales or do I want to solve customer problems? In my case, I'm going to say increase sales. And how do I want to do that? Do I want to talk to the customers or do I want to automate conversations? I'm going to select this one here. You can actually select all four of these if you like. It's not an either or situation, but the more particular you are, the better that Tidio will be able to help you. Next up, how many support agents will use Tidio? You don't have to be the only one involved. In my case, I'm just going to say one, but if you have other team members, you can specify that here. And then lastly, what is your industry? Well, in my cases, I'm going to call myself a service. And how many inquiries do I get a month? I'm going to estimate somewhere in the realm of 26 to 250. Step three in our setup process is how we want to greet our customers or greet our visitors on our page. So how would we like to engage with them at first? Do we want to ask them if they'd like to get a closer look at your offer? Ask them if they'd like to order a phone call or request a phone call, or just greet them warmly. And you can see the example here on the right-hand side, the differences between them. I'm going to say this last one here. Hey, if you need any assistance, I'm always here. I like sort of the gentle nature of this, but again, depending on your goals, depending on what you're wanting, you can choose another option. You also always have the choice to customize this message if you like as well. We're going to select continue. And lastly, our final step is to actually set this up with our site. Now, you can either do this manually or use one of the popular integrations down below. In our example, we are going to set this up for our Shopify store. So at this stage, all we need to do is insert our Shopify store name and then connect it to our Shopify account. And once Tidio is configured, I can log into my Shopify account. And at the very bottom here, here under apps, you can see that it has been installed as an application. So there's nothing really more I need to do here within my Shopify account. Now that things have been connected, every time that I launch this particular site, this particular store, that chatbot will be visible on the front. So here within our Tidio account, we want to come down to this icon here called Lyro. Lyro AI is the engine that powers the responses, but also allows you to configure the answers and the questions that may be presented to your customers and those who are visiting your website or Shopify page. Here within the data sources menu, we have two different ways in which we can start to add knowledge. Knowledge is going to be the information that we tell our chatbot to use so that when a visitor asks a question, it can confidently give a number of answers that are accurate and on brand. Now, there are two different ways in which we can do this. We can either import or generate a number of Q&As. And if you already have an FAQ, a frequently asked questions part of your site, this is super simple. But we can also simply give it a website URL, where it will take all of the information from your sales page and then use that to answer questions. So let's use both of these in this example. So starting with the website option, I'm going to select website URL, and here I just need to paste in the name of the website I want to refer it to. In this case, I'm going to use my Streamline Academy website page. I understand that there's a lot of information here within this page, and although I think it's clearly laid out, I realize that many of my visitors will simply scan and browse and maybe just read the bolded lines here. But if they have a question, I want to be able to refer them to the actual information, the accurate data, which is included on this page. Now, it may take several minutes for Lyro to scan and grab all of that information, but at this point, you can also consider adding additional websites if you need to as well. Next up, while we're waiting, let's go to the Q&A section. So if you already have an FAQ section, you want to use this option here, but you can also use this in conjunction with generating Q&As. So I'm going to click this option here, and I'm again going to state that Streamline Academy page. I'm going to say generate, and what it's going to do is scan this site, and after a few minutes, it's going to create 25 questions and answers, things that I can review and edit if I need to, so that it can give the best possible answers to those who visit my website. And once completed, it's going to give me a summary of each of the questions along with the answers below that I can choose to add, or if I don't want to include it, I can uncheck a box here. I'm going to go ahead and say add selected for everything on this page because I can still edit it here, so I can go through it one at a time. So, for example, can I reschedule my appointment or reservation? Here's the answer that the chatbot is going to give. Yes, you can do so. Please contact our customer service team. I don't have a customer service team, so here I can come in here and modify this to include an email address or give it some other instructions if desired. Once we're happy with providing it with the information that we need and editing any of these questions if necessary, we also want to come down to the configuration option here, and in particular, look at the handoff section. Remember, you can still use the chatbot as a one-to-one conversation tool. So if you are monitoring a conversation, you can choose to take over from the chatbot. The two options here are when operators are online, meaning when you are online, do you want to be transferred to the conversation? Or do you want to keep the conversation within AI? And secondly, when operators are offline, what do you want it to do as well? So these are two important questions for you to consider. Lastly, just before going live with your Shopify or website integration, you can come up here and select Test Lyro. Here you can actually see how the chatbot will respond to any questions that you give it. So here it's going to start us off with a sample question. Can I get personalized advice for my specific software? Of course you can. This is perfect. This is exactly the type of response I want to give it. What if I ask something like, who is Streamline for? Something along those lines. The answer, Streamline Academy is intended for individuals who want to optimize their software, specific needs, a plethora of technology tools, and wanting to simplify their technology. This is a perfect answer that really encompasses everything about what Streamline Academy is all about. So you can try and challenge your chatbot, give it some simple, give it some more complicated questions just before you go live, so you can be confident when real-time visitors go to use your chatbot. And don't forget, you can do so much more than just answer questions. You can also use your chatbot to capture leads, including email addresses, and then create email marketing campaigns all from within the Tidio platform. So if you want to keep people on your Shopify page or your website, make sure you install Tidio and give them the answers they deserve. To get started, go to tidio.com/get/simpletivity or use the link in the description down below to start using Tidio for free and upgrade anytime with 20% off. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive doesn't need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.